Let me share with you a story. It was 2014 October at Pune, Maharashtra. I was playing the World Junior Chess Championship. This was my last tournament as a junior and I really wanted to win it. Mainly for two reasons. First, it was being held in India, my home ground. And second, the winner qualified to play the Women's World Chess Championship. I had made the best preparations for this tournament. I had thought the tournament throughout how every round would go, but however I tried, I could not win this tournament and finished only fourth. Overall, it was a good performance because it was a very strong tournament, but in my mind, the tournament was a disaster. And in just a few days of the completion of this tournament, I was to play at the National Women's Championship. And this time, incidentally, the national champion would also qualify to play at the Women's World Chess Championship. Having spent all my strength and energy into the World Juniors, I decided to take another approach for this tournament. I decided to let it all go, not think about the results at all, and take one game at a time. And I even simplified it further for me and thought to take into consideration only my next move, only the next moment. And this approach worked and I won the tournament even a round to spare. But we may say that the preparations I did for the World Juniors helped me to win the national title. But then wouldn't it have been enough for me to just focus on my next move during the World Juniors as well? Fast forward to 2017, I have won the national title thrice by now and was aiming for my fourth consecutive national title. As forgetful humans, we forget the many life lessons we learn along the way. But life is kind and it tries to teach us until we learn the lessons by heart. So going into the 2017 championship, I was back at expecting myself to win the tournament and thinking ahead for all the rounds. I started the tournament very well. With 5 out of 6, I was leading the tournament midway. Before the rest day, for some unavoidable reasons, we had to move our stay. You will get to know why these details are important later. And on the rest day, I participated on the day of activities which were organized by the organizers. It was a lot of fun day. But unlike 2014, this time after the rest day, things were about to take a very interesting turn. The first game after the rest day I lost and some 100 things went through my head. Maybe it was because I changed my winning rule or maybe I had too much fun on the rest day. With all this background noise, I prepared for my next game and I won it. So I thought to myself, okay, I'm still in the race. I am going to win all my remaining games and win the tournament. You see, the alarm bell in my head was still not ringing. But I was about to get my lesson in the very next game, which I lost. At first, I did not understand how I had let it happen. But then calming down and at dinner table, having squandered my lead and advantage at the tournament, I decided to just do one thing which I could do now, that was to focus on my next move. And in this penultimate game, I got a very good position from the opening, but I made some mistakes and the game was slipping. I realized the game was slipping through my fingers. So I decided to force the game into a variation which would end it in a draw. And this in a way helped me, that because going into the final round, now 4 players could win the tournament, including me. The final round was starting at 9 o'clock in the morning and I decided to just focus on my game and not look at the 3 other games going adjacent to my board. Just focus on my next move and how I was going to play, because my opponent could play a great game against me, but even there was no time to think about it. This helped me and I won my game. And surprisingly, the other games also went my way and I won the tournament. Oftentimes, we go about looking for solutions in a myriad different ways for even the most simple things in life. But often those are also the times to forget about it all, forget about the solutions, the outcomes, or the way out. And the best way is the one where we just make the next one move in a happy, calm, and relaxed state of mind. That's the key to chess and perhaps everything else in life. In this question from the penultimate round of the 2017 National Championship, which I spoke about earlier, which ended in a draw, I thought ahead for 9 moves because that's exactly what this question demanded. But every move we make changes the position. Maybe we will have new opportunities or new challenges, and we have to be ready to make, to adjust to the new situation and make our next move accordingly. So yes, I do think it's a good idea to think 10 moves ahead, to make long-term plans, have big ideas and ambitions. It guides us towards a larger goal, something better, something beautiful. But life is unexpected and unanticipated. It evolves chaotically in many different ways. And hence, to deal with the certain nuances of the new situation which life puts on us on a daily basis, making the next one move is an interesting way to go about life, chess, and everything else. Take a pause, think over your puzzle, and make the next move. Everything else will fall into place. Thank you.